Welcome to Reflective Minds. Today we are going to read a short story, and it is one of my favorite by Terry Bisson. Terry Bisson is an American science fiction fantasy author. He is best known for his short stories, including Bears Discover Fire and They Are Made Out of Meat. That's what we are going to read out today. Terry Bisson is the author of 6 novels, and the most recently published that was in 2003 was Dear Abby. You must check them out. I have provided the link of this story in the description box. Okay, let's start. They are made out of meat. 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 They are made out of meat. Meat. There is no doubt about it. We picked up several from the different parts of the planet. They took them abroad, our recon vessels, and probed them all the way through. They are completely meat. That's impossible. What about the radio signals? The messages to the stars? They use the radio waves to talk, but the signals don't come from them. The signals come from the machines. So, who made the machines? That's who we want to contact. They made the machines. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Meat made the machines. That's ridiculous. How can meat make a machine? You're asking me to believe in sentient meat? I'm not asking you. I'm telling you, these creatures are the only sentient race in that sector, and they are made out of meat. Photomimics. Maybe they are like a audio folio. You know, a carbon-based intelligence that goes through a meat stage. Nope. They are born meat. They die meat. We studied them for the several of their life spans, which didn't take long. Do you have any idea what the life span of meat? Spare me. Okay, maybe they are only part meat, you know, like the Vedelili, a meat head with an electron plasma brain inside? No, we thought of that. Since they do not have meat hands like the Vedelili, but I told you, we probed them. They are meat all the way through. No brain? Oh, there is a brain, all right. It's just that the brain is made out of meat. That's what I have been trying to tell you. So, what does the thinking? You are not understanding, are you? You are refusing to deal with what I'm telling you. The brain does the thinking, the meat. Thinking meat? You are asking me to believe in thinking meat. Yes, thinking meat, conscious meat, loving meat. Dreaming meat, that the meat is the whole deal. Are you beginning to get the picture, or do I have to start all over again? Oh my God, you are serious then. They are meat. They are made out of meat. Thank you. Finally, yes, they are indeed made out of meat, and they have been trying to get in touch with us for almost 100 of their years. Oh my God, so what does this meat have in mind? First, it wants to talk to us, then I imagine it wants to explore the universe, contact other scientists, swap ideas and information, the usual. We are supposed to talk to meat. That's the idea, that's the message they are sending out by radio. Hello, anyone out there, anybody home, that sort of thing. They actually do talk then, they use words, ideas, concepts. Oh yes, except they do it with meat. I thought you just told me they use radio. They do, but what do you think is on the radio? Meat sound. You know how when you slap or flap meat, it makes a noise. They talk by flapping their meat at each other. They can even sing or squirting air through their meat. Oh my God, singing meat? This is altogether too much. So what do you advise, officially or unofficially? Both. Officially, we are required to contact Welcome and log in any and all sentient races or multi-beings in the quadrant of the universe. without prejudice, fear or favor. Unofficially, I advise that we erase the records and forget the whole thing. I was hoping you would say that. It seems harsh, but there is a limit. Do we really want to make contact with meat? I agree 100%. What's there to say? Hello, meat. How's it going? But will this work? How many planets are we dealing with here? Just one. They can travel to other planets in special meat containers, but they can't live on them. And being meat, they can only travel through the sea space, which limits them to the speed of light and makes the possibility of their ever making contact pretty slim. Infinite, in fact. So we just pretend there's no one home in the universe. That's it. That's cruel. But you said it yourself. Who wants to meet meat? And the ones who have been abroad are vessels. The one you probed, you are sure they won't remember. They will be considered crackpots if they do. We went into their heads and smoothed out their meat so that we are just a dream to them. A dream to meat. How strangely appropriate that we should be meat's dream. And we marked the entire sector unoccupied. Good. Agreed. Officially and unofficially. Case closed. And others? Anyone interesting on the side of the galaxy? Yes, a rather shy but sweet hydrogen core cluster intelligence in the class 9 star in G445 zone was in contact 2 galactic rotations ago. Wants to be friendly again. Oh, they always come around. And why not? Imagine how unbearably, how unutterably cold the universe would be if one were all alone. The end. This story originally appeared in the Omni April 1991 and was nominated for Nebula Award. It is taken from the collection Bears Discovered Fire, available here. As I mentioned, the link is in the description. You can find more about the Terry Burton on this website. The link is again in the description box. So I hope you like this story. I love this story. Let's do it. If you like this content, we can do more of these kinds of stories. Thank you. Have a great day. Thank you for watching The Reflective Mind. Bye.